Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to episode 21 of LabPadre, SpaceX, and Starbase weekly updates. We've got another load of goods for you today, so let's dig in. Starting off the week at Starbase on Friday morning, a cage-like structure was spotted on a self-propelled modular transporter leaving the dome yard area and heading to Sanchez. Around the same time, the red TNT crane began lifting crates of windows up to the top level of Mega Bay for installation. Meanwhile, down at the launch site, the new Raptor work platform was lifted from its stand and placed on the ground on the former landing pad. Rover 2 cam spotted a replacement road sign near the suborbital farm gate that now shows the curve in the road correctly. That afternoon, with the platform laying open on the ground, crews were spotted applying some kind of paint or sealant to its top surface. Over at the orbital launch mount, workers were seen power washing the deck and awnings, washing off the soot and debris from Booster 7's anomaly. Crews were busy under Ship 24, evaluating how it held up to the week's tests and preparing for more soon. That evening, with work on the new Raptor platform done for the day, it was lifted and returned to its stand. Late Friday night, Rover Cam spotted a forklift transporting what appeared to be a new Raptor boost engine from Tent 3 to Mega Bay. Later, a Raptor went from Mega Bay to Tent 3. It is unclear if it was the same one. Saturday morning at Port Canaveral, Tug Kurt J. Crosby towed Just Read the Instructions out to sea. Back at Starbase, a trailer with the new prefabricated sections of cryogenic piping was delivered to the launch site. After first turning into the main gate, the delivery was redirected to the orbital tank farm. That afternoon, Ship 28's payload section was rolled out of the high bay before moving into the direction of the tents. A few hours later, a crane removed the old cryogenic piping from the LOX pump area of the orbital tank farm. Next, the crane lifted the newly delivered replacement section of pipe and lowered it into the same area of the farm. Later, the old pipework was seen being driven away from the launch site. Meanwhile, back at the production site, Ship 25's mid-8 stack was rolled out of the mid-bay and into high bay. Saturday evening, an unfamiliar truck arrived at the build site. It is believed this could be a Starlink delivery vehicle. A short time later, the Starlink loader was rolled out of the new building by the crane yard and parked nearby. The next potential Starlink delivery truck turned out of the build site and headed that direction. Around that same time, over at the orbital tank farm, a crane was seen removing one of the methane pumps. Back at the apparent payload building, with the Starlink loader out of the way, the delivery truck was back into the building. Over at the production site, two self-propelled modular transporters, both loaded with counterweights, were moved into Mega Bay. A short time later, the door of the payload building opened again briefly, allowing the truck to roll out, leaving the trailer behind. Just over 10 minutes later, the door was again open, this time to allow the Starlink loader to be rolled back inside. Sunday morning, GatorCam caught the SpaceX Falcon 9 launch of the Starlink 4-25 mission from Launch Complex 39A, which successfully delivered another 53 Starlink satellites to low Earth orbit. That night, the SPMTs with counterweights that had previously rolled into Mega Bay were moved back out. Monday morning, a worker set up a surveying tripod next to the guardhouse at the D2 gate to take some measurements. Workers began disconnecting the straps that connect to the top hat to the hydraulic rams on the base of the can crusher. Meanwhile, SpaceX's LR11000 crane began rolling across the landing pad on its way over to the can crusher. In Florida, Just Read the Instructions was towed back into the port after spending a few days offshore, possibly for an annual hull inspection. Back at the Starbase launch site, a single SPMT arrived at the launch site carrying a half a dozen pipe stands. Once all the straps were secured to that top hat, workers hooked it up to a waiting crane. Once everything was ready, the crane lifted the top hat off of B7.1 and placed it on the SPMT that had arrived earlier. It was then driven around all the equipment on the landing pad before being parked near the E-Dome test tank. Workers in forklifts then placed the six pipe stands under the outer ring of the top hat, and then the SPMT lowered it, setting it down into the waiting stands. A short time later, the SPMT rolled out from under the top hat and left the launch site. On Monday evening, with the road still open, some venting was seen coming from under the skirt of Ship 24. Early Tuesday, a four-ring section, or quad, was moved from the ring yard and taken towards the production tents. A truck arrived at the B2 gate with new sections of a Starship stand. After checking in, the truck turned around to deliver its load elsewhere on the property. At the launch site, crews installed pressure control valves onto the vent from the top of B7.1's forward dome in preparation for additional testing. That afternoon, a three-ring section, or triple, likely destined for Booster 9, was rolled into Mega Bay. Just a short time later, that triple section was followed into Mega Bay by another likely Booster 9 quad section. Booster 9's six-ring partial methane tank section was briefly stacked on the top of the triple before later being destacked. The six-ring upper methane section was briefly moved outside overnight before making its way back into Mega Bay. Tuesday afternoon, part of the TNT crane jib left Starbase after the crane spent several days lifting material to the top of Mega Bay. Wednesday, the old booster test stand adapter at Sanchez was removed from the stand it had been attached to. Wednesday also brought us another round of testing on the B7.1 test tank. With can crushing finished, it seemed SpaceX wanted some pressure testing. The tank was filled with cryogenics and then the vents shut off, allowing pressure to build. They seemed to cycle through this twice before final detanking. Our man on the ground in Florida, photographer Greg Scott, was live Wednesday evening from outside the vertical assembly building for the rollout of the fifth section of the LC-39A Starship launch tower. As the section rolled by, we could see that SpaceX had already installed a lot of conduit, some hydraulic accumulators, and the hydraulic actuator that will be moving the QD arm. Early Thursday morning, some significant venting was seen from the purge valve under the booster quick disconnect on the launch mount against a beautiful sunrise backdrop. A few hours later, SpaceX support ship Doug towed a shortfall of Gravitas into port with Falcon 9 booster B1062 following the successful Starlink 4-25 mission. Back at Starbase, two 20-ton bridge cranes were delivered to the build site, likely destined for the new support beams installed in Star Factory. That afternoon, the Black Buckner crane was seen moving the rails for these bridge cranes. These bridge crane rails will ride on the beams in Star Factory while carrying the bridge crane trolley. Meanwhile, in Florida, B1062 was lifted off a shortfall of Gravitas and placed on the dock for processing. Thursday afternoon, crews and man lifts unchained all four flaps on Ship 24. Once the flaps were free, they were tested and left extended. Back at the build site, the scrapping of Booster 5 continued as its grid fins were removed from what was left of its forward dome section. The grid fins were cut free just inside the inner stage section, while a telehandler outside used its forks to finish knocking the grid fins free. Finally for this week, the new payload building is being painted white, possibly to better reflect sunlight and help keep the building cool. And there you have it, another SpaceX and Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. Make sure you subscribe and hit the alert bell for new video and live stream notifications. We'll see you next week, and thanks for watching. LabPadre out.